So both teams in, clear to join. So here we are, IGL week one. Tier 5, Div 4. It's on the west end of things. Butt Ledge there, captain of Empire Hive. His Fennec looks... I like that. Pass there, Bear. Gets his... Captain said he might have a big game, but I'm pretty sure he just listed everyone from his team when I asked who's going to be MVP. Butt Ledge touches. Who's out there in the back? Is it Mako? Alright, gotta learn the names real quick, but we're chilling. Butt Ledge! No go, Carbon! Puts it out. Butt Ledge takes a pass and guides it over to the orange net, but nothing drops! And Bear almost rockets it into the orange net. A lot of pressure from Empire Hive early. Let's see, but now the ball's on their end of the field. Touch there from Mako. Nice swooping in. Carbon gets it to go 1-0 Idaho. Good play there.
That was legitness.
It seems like once he decided it was time. And he just let it rip. So a minute gone. We have our first points of the game there. So Alpha. Good play. And Butt Ledge tries to get the save, but Seffy puts one in.
Oh, like that!
Nice hop. He's using the defender's momentum to take him out of the play and just pops it over him on the cheek. Let's see what we have here. First a nice goal, then a second one to round it up, and then Sethy wanted a third for his team, but that's a no-go there. Touch from Alpha. Sethy cuts the field. Sethy was quiet first early, in the early going of this game one. Nice save there.
It's definitely an Alpha kill.
Touch, Carbon. Not quite. Mako and the Dominus, my main, not quite, decent pass, but Sethy is left chasing the ball, trying to catch back up to it. Touch there, Butt Ledge rolls it, you gotta think he wanted more pepper on it. Touch there from Bear, good contest. Alpha, 52 members of the Whippers. Now they're back around. Bear trying to control it. Beats one man, but Carbon is back on it and booms it into the corner. Come back in on a cross. Almost does it himself, but gets a demo instead.
Damn it, Bobby.
Touch there, coming down to a two-minute mark. Alpha touches Carbon. Takes it. 50, Bear ceiling up. Mako can't quite handle it. And Sethy got bumped, or else he might have scored the third goal. Let's see Butt Ledge. I think he has full boost. Pops it up. It gets past Sethy. He helps it along. So yeah, after those two goals, things have kind of slowed down a little bit. There's been plenty of shots, plenty of saves, but you know, we only count points here. Butt Ledge puts it out. Alpha helps it cross. Sethy keeps it from waterfalling. And Alpha should have probably had the shot there. Another demo.
Get him a body bag. Yeah.
Alpha backboard, but Carbon is already up in the air to handle any would-be shooters. Coming down to the minute. Again, this is a best of five. Another demo I hear. Down around. job there. There. Not quite. Mako stops it before it's able to cross. Now he's got the ball. Not quite dribbling, but definitely taking it the field. And almost did it himself, but Carbon was there waiting to shoot. Now Sethi trying to prevent that clear that just happened there. Crossing. No go. Mako touches. Now Bear. Coming around. Good cross. And now, just like that, it is 1-2. And just like that, they are right back in this game. About half a minute to go left in this game one. Buttledge finishes it up. I'm so glad he came into the chat early to explain to me how that's set. Bob down, Carbon. He's looked quick, definitely has a nose for the ball. This may be trouble. As it'll go, not quite! And this one may, it definitely flips. They could score. Coming down, 7 seconds. Buttledge, good cross. He has a teammate, but Mako saves it. It needs to hit the turf, and it will land in the snow. I just noticed that you guys should be good. Mako with the MVP. I did feel like I called his name a lot. So 442, zero goals. That's the second time that's happened to me today. So let me clarify something really quick. Here we are, game two, best of five. Whiffers have already gone up 1-0 in the series. Oh, a shot opportunity there. Kind of squandered by Buttledge. Up, Buttledge tracking it back down. Good, smart, savvy play there. Alpha was trying to help, and I think he did delay a touch. Alpha up. Puts it ceiling down. Lot of action on this, on the blue side of this field, just like we saw last game. Except now here, Alpha finds a crease, goes up, one more man to beat, but it's Carbon and he is hard to get the ball around. Clamp Dog says, yes sir. What up, Clamp? Pretty sure you pop it in. Nice 50 there, ceiling up, down, Buttledge, no go. Did Wado win? I don't know if you're making a joke, but it's Woda. And no, it went all five games, and yeah, they lost. They ended up losing by one. It was a crazy series. Mako touches 50. 0-0s on this game so far. After a very, very eventful game one. Sethi stops it, gives it right back to Bear. Bear going up, double tap, almost, as it drifts off to the edge into the orange corner there. Buttledge touches. Carbon puts it out, but Bear swings it right back around. And now it's the Whiffers who are kind of on their heels a little bit, trying to play defense, trying to get any clear that they can. Carbon touches, but that won't be enough. And now Boost becoming a concern, but he picks up 100. Goes up. No go. Butt ledge. Fakes.
Bond, stop trying to hit me and hit me.
2 minutes. No, and genuinely messed up his name. No, Wodo. I've never heard that name before, so I understand it. But Wodo is funny. Nice pinch there from Butt ledge. 0-0. 2 minutes. Alpha goes to meet Mako, but our MVP from last game gets the better of it. This one may go in, and it does. Mako working on a second MVP performance here. About a minute 45 left. A lot of love in the in-game chat. Like to see it. I just went dyslexic on the O and A. Yeah. Comes out. Demo there.
Puppy!
And a no-touch from Butt Ledge. Keeps it around, keeps the contention, but Mako is just very, very quick. So far, the Whiffers seem like they're maybe a half step closer than these Empire Hype boys. Or Hive, sorry. Touch there, Bear. He's got a look. Tries to muscle it through Alpha. He can't touch, and now Mako, who's having himself a good series so far, stays on it. Comes around. The Whiffers are 60 seconds away from their second game win of the series. Mocha? Is it Mocha? No way. Okay, no, it's Mako. I don't know if he's referencing the Sharks. But I have agreed to a post-game interview with both captains. So, chat, if you remember, we can ask about Mako's name. See what it is. Bear. Backboard. No, Carbon puts it out. Sends Alpha chasing in the corner, but it hops him. A fortunate bounce for the Whiffers. The no-go there. Big boom from Mako.
I wouldn't venture out there, fellas. This sniper's got talent.
Nice shot from him. Just using that long, narrow point that the Dominus offers and putting it straight over across the field into the net. Good play. And that may be the go-ahead goal for game two. There, opportunity, put it in, and they did something very similar last game, was make it close with seconds left, but that one doesn't fall the way they hope. And Mako, another MVP performance, 466, 2 goals, a save, only 3 shots from the Whiffers, but 2 of them counted. So if Clamp Dog is here, he might be able to give us the percentage. He's a smart dude. But good plays here. Seffy, a little slow to ready up, but he does. And Empire Hive, I mean, chat, feel free to chime in if you see something I'm not seeing. But it seems like they're kind of in their own way at the moment. The rotations aren't quite there, and when they do get a good scoring opportunity, someone from the Whiffers is able to clear it out or get in the way in the nick of time. So it's rough. Says all that high, another demo. And Mako.
Play him. Pay that man his money.
And Mako is just running amok all over this field. He gets the demo, clears the field for himself, sets the table, and shoots the shot. And I don't know if you're keeping track, but he's already been MVP for both of his team's wins. Kakaranda says a lot of double and triple commit. Yeah, that's what I keep seeing. Here comes Bear. Okay, so we do have a substitution. from Empire Hive. Touch backboard, that is. I can't see his name quite yet. It's Laughing Nuck. Alright, let's see. Let's see if he can maybe provide something. If he's a little more patient, he could perhaps be a breath of fresh air for Empire Hive. Something they desperately need. Good touch, and it'll go in. Good shot by Bear. Just catches them looking. Mako. Yeah, see, even Mako didn't think he had his. He comes just a little too far away from the goal, and now we have a tied game. Yeah, they subbed out Buttledge. Yeah, Buttledge is the captain. I respect being able to seat yourself. I definitely don't mind doing that, but Laughing Nuck! I was talking about the patience. Perhaps a little too patient there. As that one doesn't get to go. Tied up. Some whiffs there, but Alpha gets bumped as he's trying to make something happen. And Laughing Nuck comes off the bench and into the net, onto the scoreboard. He saw Mako take out their first shooter, and he comes in 50s, just very fortunate 50 for them, but those count all the same. So now Empire Hive, if I'm not mistaken, enjoying their first lead of this series. So at this point, they just need to hang on to it. And just like I said, Laughing Nuck, I don't know if it's his style to play patient, but he's always in the back midfield. So it looks like he's a good remedy to the double and triple committing that we observed earlier. That one sneaks in. Alpha picks up the 100, slides the ball out, gets a clear, beats the last man, and Mako is chasing it in. And now Alpha is getting it going.
So, you like kicking butts, do ya?
Great play there by So Alpha. And that's what proper rotations can give you. You get everyone, you get everyone positioned correctly out of each other's way, and it just gives everyone else some breathing room to perform. I mean, if you're here playing it at this level, chances are you're a good player. You just need the room and space and proper decision making. Goes around here, Carbon gets smoked up. Ooh. Touch there, 3-1. Laughing Nuck tries the lob one in. Mako tries to dart it away from his net, but it comes right back to him as now it's Empire Hive applying some pressure of their own here. Demo there.
Boom, baby!
Carbon catches Bear. Pops it, and Bear almost finished. He's going to give a cursing quick chat there. And yeah, he probably should have had that, and he knows it. Perhaps goal number 4, as So Alpha is just letting it go now, 4-1. Great 50 there, nice dunk if you will. And finishes up his supper, 4-1. As we have a techno party in the, or maybe EDM, sorry. I don't know these things. Coming around, Alpha. Alpha gets a demo of his own.
Mother trucker, dude.
Touches down 4-1. This may be sealed up, but we've seen the whiffers catch fire. So we'll see if they can end this game 3 strong. They were looking for perhaps the sweep. So we'll see how they respond. We'll see if Empire Hive stays with his personnel. We had the captain seat himself, Buttledge, for Laughing Nuck, and you know, obviously you see the results. But time will tell if that was just a fluke, something that went down that way, or Carbon tries to pass back. I think I saw rule 1. This one may go in and Bear. 5-1.
Cristiano del área, sigue Cristiano. ¡No!
5-1, the rule one. Everyone was, well, not everyone, but two players tied up on the midfield boost off to the left, and Bear just runs it down. Touch from Alpha. Slices out. Bear puts it in. And no, and look, now we have the Whiffers who are kind of feeling the heat, feeling the pressure, and now they're starting to double and triple commit. And Bear, good clears. Mako, who has had the hot hand in this series, has taken a step back, understandably so, in this game three. Alpha touches. Bear 50s. Coming around. And Laughing Nuck. And as soon as this hits the snow, not another goal. 6-1. One shy for Brazil. And Bear is having, he had a game there, several own goals, including that buzzer beater own goal, 6-1. And you gotta believe the Whiffers just want to do their best to forget that performance there. Let's see how they respond. And again, we're gonna need to see the personnel that Empire Hive chooses here. They still have their work cut out for them. They're down 2-1 in the best of five series, so it has been match point. We'll see how they act here and play it through. Get a look at the personnel. Okay. Buttledge does stay out. I respect it, Bear. Coming, Laughing Nuck. Wanted some speed on that. And Carbon, who was very, very quiet that last game, you know, as much of his team was, comes in and almost gets his team to a lead early. Mako's up, 50s. And that was a bit of a triple. But I'm not sure that the Hive was positioned to turn that into points. Which is tragic. If you ever get the team, the opposing team that is, to triple commit, you gotta make the most of that. That's should be the equivalent to an open net. Come here, good dunk by Bear. He's gonna keep it going. But here comes Carbon. Still playing for the hills! And a close one from Alpha, who had a very big game himself. Going around, he takes it there. Touch around, zeros. Laughing Nuck. Beats two, but that third man back gets an ultra clear as they continue to jostle. Alpha, booming, beats one man. It's got Sethi to beat, beats him. Carbon flicks it up. This could be shot at. Backboard shooter. And Bear cannot get it to go. Touching. Mako again. Two MVPs under his belt in this series. And just nothing really working for him since. Touch there, Carbon. Chasing it backboard. Sethi goes up there to meet him. Not what they wanted. Mako, we've seen a lot of good power shots from him early. Nice power cross. A demo there.
Why would you kill him like that?
And Bear will stroll it on in. 1-0. Bear, why would you kill them like that? Good play there, 1-0. as we are coming up on the halfway mark of this game four. Obviously, the Hive trying to force the game five. Alpha coming up, ceiling pass down. It does come, but Bear was turned around. Bear pops a good cross, but Mako acts swiftly. And yeah, it looks like night and day with this Empire Hive offensive attack. They're really picking their shots, going one at a time, maintaining disciplined positioning on the back end. But that only helps so much. You have to make your touches. When O'Bear gets it slipped past him, Carbon K5 1-1. Went quiet these last two games, but there we are. As I was complimenting the rotations of Empire Hive, we have a miscue there that results in the Whippers' first goal of game four. Bear coming around. Corner hops in, cross. Not quite. I didn't see who that was. I believe it was Carbon that prevented it from going. Laughing Nut from sailing in. No go from him. Touch there, Bear. Crossing. A lot of action on the blue side of the field here. Sethi gets beat. Out of position. Two men beat, but Mako acting as a bit of a security blanket for the Whiffers at the moment, which may not behoove them considering he's also their leading scorer, especially as in-game points are concerned. Sethi helps it along. Pass to Carbon. Carbon is going to go toe-to-toe with the Nuck, but beats him, runs out of boost, and then Mako gets sidestepped by Bear. And we may get overtime in this game four here, because up to this point, no one has really got a clear-cut advantage. Nice touch from Bear. Mako touches. Carbon pops it. Oh, he's got one man, Alpha. Haven't heard from him in a bit, but he's laying in the weeds, preventing a cheap goal. This one looks like it. And it did waterfall. Another opportunity. Triple commit there, but a nice hard touch from Alpha. As he's past the team, he may cross it here. Shooter, not quite. Everyone was kind of reeling from the play. Carbon with the go-ahead goal. Oh, God. What a play. Carbon just, as a last-ditch effort, puts it on, and Bear.
Keep the change, you filthy animal.
The own goal that will haunt his dreams for the rest of week one in IGL. And that will do it, and the Whiffers escape by the skin of their teeth, because that, for all intents and purposes, should have been an overtime. But here we have Carbon. 508, two goals. We'll hear from him right now as the winning captain. We will get that post-game interview going. Sphinx says, poor guy. Yeah, that's the thing. We've all been there, and it's, you know, it doesn't make it sting any less. So let me call out to Carbon and go over that crazy, crazy series. Carbon,
how's it going?
How you doing, man? Can you hear me okay?
Yeah, I can hear you.
All right, you got a little help there at the end. How you feel about it?
It was pretty close.
Tell me about the voice chat or the voice comms when that own goal took place at the end there.
Everybody was screaming, man.
who gets the most hype in your comms?
I think that would be me.
There would be you. So you're the captain. Do you also serve as the voice of reason and the tactical talker as well, or speaker?
I guess you could say it's really a team effort.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that works. So let's talk about it, man. You guys come out, two games, just rattle them off quick. What'd you see there in those first two games?
I think we were just kind of didn't know what to expect. It's our first time doing this. Right. So we were just kind of going in there having fun. So when we got to the third game, we kind of got a little nervous, started falling apart. So we tried to regroup towards that fourth game.
Okay. Dang, you almost had the sweep, but you think nerves maybe got the better in game three?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. All right. So did you say this was your first IGL?
Yes, it's our first IGL.
Okay. You know what? That's funny. It's the same thing with the Empire Hive. So welcome. Welcome. It's a lot of fun. You got your first win, which is not always such an easy feat. So congrats there. Who are you giving the game ball to?
Mako, man.
Is it Mako? I was saying Mako the whole damn time. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
It's either or. Sometimes we go Mako Cheese.
Mako Cheese, I like that. Yeah, if I have you guys on the stream again, I should be able to remember that. But I like Mako Cheese. Yeah, he had a good game on those, or a good series, rather. On those first two games, he walked away with MVP. And yeah, he had a very, very strong presence on the field. And then even in those close games, he was just hanging out in the back. He was there for those big booming clears and helping out the team. So yeah, he looked good for sure. But how long have you guys been playing together as a team?
Probably a little bit over a year. We started playing together, and we have others that play with us. Right. We just didn't get them to join the roster.
Darn. Well, you know, you can add to the roster unless they changed it. And, you know, maybe I shouldn't misspeak here, but you should be able to add to the roster throughout the season. It's they cut it off at playoffs after week six.
Yeah, we're definitely going to look into that.
So yeah, that's worth looking into, because, yeah, 6 weeks, it seems like a longer time than – it's a deceptively long amount of time, I'll say. So having those extra members definitely helps out. But definitely subs help as well, because just as you saw with Empire Hive, I'm not sure you noticed, they had a substitution there. Probably helped them a lot too, because they were able to work a lot better and do a little more.
I think that's the other thing that kind of threw us off when he came in, is a slightly different play style, so right. It kind of caught us off guard.
Right, that's what me and the chat were kind of going back and forth with it. When Buttledge was in there, they were kind of a little chasey, kind of getting each other's way, which, you know, makes it pretty easy for you guys, but. Their sub was able to sit back and hang out, and it cleared a lot of space for them. But anything else do you want to go over? Any shout outs you want to give? Anything you want to plug, perhaps?
No, just a good job on the commentary. It really pumped up the game.
Thank you. Were you listening throughout?
I listened in into the first two games, and okay. Then afterwards I kind of concentrated.
Yeah. good wise. Yeah. Yeah, the VODs go up on Twitch, of course, and then I export them to my YouTube channel, so you'll always have it there if you want to watch back with the team or whatever.
All right, cool, thanks. All
right. Anything else?
No.
All right, man, congrats. Welcome to IGL, and good luck the rest of the way.
Thank you.